Thank you for choosing the 11x13 Meridian Gazebo from Yardistry. We're confident you'll find the assembly straightforward as long as you work through each step in the assembly manual. In addition, this helpful hints video offers tips and tricks that we've learned along the way for handling some of the more critical steps. Step 1. Inventory. Before beginning assembly, sort your inventory by laying out each of the wood parts and hardware on the ground. Then, using the stamps or marked reference numbers, take a few minutes to cross-reference each one with the list in the assembly manual. Remember, we are always here to help. Contact us if you find a part that is damaged or missing. Take a moment to record the carton ID stamp for each box that you receive. There is a space on page 12 of your instruction manual to write down the first 5 digits that come before 14459 and also the letter at the end. Step 2. Post-assemblies. In Step 2, when installing the post mounts to the bottom of the posts, keep the bolts loose. Place and attach a plinth on each side of the post so it is flush to the bottom and sides, then secure the post mounts tight to the bottom and inside edge of the posts with screws. It's okay to install the screws on the inside of the posts on an angle. Once secured, go back and tighten the bolts. Step 3. Short beam assembly, Part 1. It is best to do Step 3 on a raised surface that is flat and solid. Put T-nuts into the notched end of the beam short LT as shown here. You'll know it's the beam short LT because the notch in one end of the board will face down when the angle on the other end faces up. Now, flip the beam short LT over and connect the beam short RT and the beam short LT so the notches fit tight together. Have a helper align the boards from one end so they are flush, while another secures with bolts. Next, insert T-nuts into the short beam end RT and short beam end LT as shown, then flip the boards over. Place one short beam center on top of the short beam ends so the notches fit tight together. Make sure the side of the short beam ends with a wider gap from the edge of the board to the T-nuts lines up with the side of the short beam center that has the gusset holes. If they don't, flip the short beam center around. When the short beam ends are aligned correctly and flush with the short beam center, secure with bolts. Step 3. Short beam assembly, Part 2. To complete the short beam assembly, lay the short beam LR assembly down so the angled ends are facing up, then place the short beam end assembly on top of it, again, so the angled ends are facing up. Make sure the gusset holes in both beams align and insert long hex bolts into a few of the bolt holes temporarily to help keep the beams in place. When positioned correctly so that the mitered ends of the beams are flush, secure each end with wood screws. If the mitered ends are not flush on the second end of the beam, loosen the bolts in the short beam end assembly. Make the necessary adjustments by hand or using the long bolt as a pry. When flush, secure the end with wood screws, then retighten the bolts. Finish the assembly by installing the rest of the wood screws and removing the long hex bolts. Step 4. Long beam assembly, Part 1. Continue to work on a solid, flat, and raised surface for Step 4. Insert the T-nuts into the beam long RT and flip it over. You'll know it's the beam long RT because the angled end will be facing up when the notched end is facing down. Connect the beam long RT and beam long LT so the notches fit tight together. Have a helper align the boards from one end so they are flush while another secures with bolts. Next, on each long beam end, insert one T-nut on the notched end. It goes on the same edge that has only one hole as shown here. Flip the long beam ends over and place one long beam center on top so the notches fit tight together. Attach with one hex bolt per end. Step 4. Long beam assembly, Part 2 and 3. With the long beam end assembly placed so the angled ends face up, install 4 T-nuts where shown here, then flip the assembly over. Place the insert onto the long beam end assembly so the recessed holes for screws face up. Make sure the holes along the bottom of the insert match up with the holes in the assembly, and the holes along the top of the long beam end assembly are not blocked by the insert. Attach the insert with screws. Now, lay the long beam LR assembly on top so the holes and mitered ends line up like this. If they don't, flip the beam around. When aligned, loosely connect the beams with 4 hex bolts. Flip the assembly over and make sure the mitered ends are flush, then secure the beam end with wood screws. If the second end is not flush, loosen the bolt in the beam end and adjust the boards. it can be helpful to use a long hex bolt as a pry. When flush, secure with screws, then retighten the bolt. To complete the assembly, secure the center with screws, then flip over the assembly and tighten the bolts. Step 5. Frame assembly and anchoring, part 1. Have two people hold the first two posts in place while others lift the long beam assembly to the outside of the posts. Take a moment to make sure the gusset holes are positioned along the bottom of the beam assembly. If not, flip the beam around. When in the correct orientation, connect the beam assembly to each post with one hex bolt. Before tightening, check that the beam is flush to the top and side of the posts. Have the person holding the posts make any necessary adjustments, then tighten the bolt. Make sure one person continues to hold the frame assembly, while the other person that was holding the posts stands a third post in position. Again, when lifting the short beam assembly into place, make sure the gusset holes are at the bottom and the beam is flush to the top and side of the post before securing with bolts. Repeat to install a second long and a second short beam assembly. When the frame is fully assembled, check to make sure all the measurements on page 19 of your instruction manual are met. It should measure 13 feet 11 inches diagonally between posts. At the front and back, along the sides of the assembly, it should measure 11 feet 8.5 inches from outside to outside of the posts. And the shorter sides of the assembly should measure 9 feet 8.5 inches from the outer edge of each post. Take some time to make sure the post assemblies are square to the beam assemblies and the beam assemblies are level. Adjust the positioning as needed. When the frame assembly is square, level, and all measurements have been met, use leg screws at each corner to secure each post in place. Step 6. Attach gussets and roof brackets. As you attach the gussets in Step 6, take a moment to re-square the post and beam assemblies. Have a helper hold the gusset in place while you attach the gusset tight and flush to the post and beam. Position a roof to post bracket at each of the top corners so that it sits tightly on the beams and fasten with screws. Step 8. Small roof rafter assembly, part 1. Continue to work on a flat and solid raised surface for step 8. Have a helper hold a rafter corner left and right tight and flush to each side of the rafter and attach with wood screws. The board should be positioned so the notches in all boards face up. It is crucial to get the positioning of the fascia beam assembly right. If the ends don't align properly, try rotating the fascia beam assembly. In the correct position, the ends will be flush to the top and outside edges of the rafter corner left and right. Secure with wood screws. Before attaching the rafter to the fascia beam assembly, make sure it is centered over the two pilot holes and flush at the top. Then, secure with wood screws. Small roof rafter assembly, part 2. If the end of the strap top or strap bottom aren't flush with the edge of the rafter corner left or right, have someone hold the boards in position, then fasten with wood screws. When you're attaching the short rafter RT and short rafter LT, fasten it at the bottom first where it connects to the fascia beam assembly, then fasten it at the top to the rafter corner left or right. Take a moment to look down each rafter corner to make sure they are straight and nothing overhangs the edge. If they aren't straight, remove the screws and have a helper hold the boards in place while you reattach the screws. Step 9. Attach roof to beam brackets to small roof rafter assembly. Flip one small roof panel assembly over and install roof to beam brackets on it. The brackets should be centered and flush to the bottom of each rafter. Step 10. Large roof rafter assembly, part 1. Continue to work on a flat and solid raised surface for step 10. With a helper holding the boards flush, attach the rafter top to each rafter. When attaching the large fascia beam assembly at the bottom, use a flat edge to check the alignment of the fascia beam assembly. If there is a gap like this, flip the beam over. In the correct position, the top of the fascia beam is flush with the top of the rafters, and the angled ends on each side of the fascia beam will face towards the top. When aligned correctly, center the rafters over the pilot holes and secure with screws. Large roof rafter assembly, part 2. Make sure each corner is flush when you install the rafter corner left and right. Get someone to hold the boards in place as you secure them. Large roof rafter assembly, part 3. Next, position the strap long in the top notches of the rafters and position the strap long LT and RT in the bottom notches of the rafters so they meet over one of the rafters. Secure each strap to the rafter corner left and right with screws, making sure the ends don't overhang. Before attaching the straps in the center, position the short rafter LT and RT underneath the strap long LT and RT. In the correct position, they will fit into the notches on the short rafter LT and RT, be centered over the pilot holes in the fascia beam assembly, and fit tight and flush to the top of the rafter corner LT and RT. Have a helper hold them in place while you attach them to the fascia beam assembly and the rafter corners. Now, secure the straps in the center. Note that the screws securing the strap long LT and RT, where they meet, are installed on an angle. Step 11. Attach roof to beam brackets to large roof panel. Flip each large roof panel assembly over and install roof to beam brackets on it. The brackets should be centered and flush to the bottom of each rafter. Step 12. Attach roof panels, small roof part 1. Notice, gloves are essential for this part of the assembly because the roofing material can have sharp edges. To prevent scuffing, remove the clear and blue plastic from both sides of the aluminum panels right before assembly. If you are using a power tool, be careful not to over-tighten the screws. We recommend hand-tightening the screws until they are snug. Step 12 should be done on a flat and solid raised surface. Place a long panel left on the small frame assembly so the side is flush to the rafter corner left. There is a slight overhang at the bottom, and the holes on the rib are centered over the center rafter. Next, place a long panel right in the same fashion so the rib overlaps the long panel left. When the panels are aligned, attach them with four roofing screws as shown here and on page 32 of your manual. Step 12. Attach roof panels, small roof, part 2. Place the short panel left onto the assembly so that the rib overlaps the long panel left. It should be flush to the edge of the rafter corner left and will have a slight overhang along the bottom. Repeat to install the short panel right. It's okay if the panel edges aren't quite flush with the rafter corners, however, they cannot overhang. If they do, loosen the roofing screws you already installed, adjust the roof panels so they are aligned correctly, then secure with roofing screws. Step 13. Attach ridge clips and roof edges, small roof. In step 13, position a roof edge left and roof edge right along the bottom of the panel assembly. Make sure the ends meet tight in the center and secure the three middle screws. Then, work your way from each end inwards. Peel away a small portion of the backing on the strip of weather seal, then begin attaching it to the rounded bottom of a ridge clip. When you're done applying the full length of weather seal, attach the ridge clip to one side of the small roof panel assembly so that it aligns with the angle of the rafter corner right or left. As long as one end is flush to the top of the roof panel, the other should not overhang. Take care not to push down on the ridge clip. When in position, attach it with screws. Repeat to attach a second ridge clip to the other side of the roof panel. Step 14. Attach roof panels, large roof, part 1. Complete step 14 on a flat and solid raised surface. Lay one large roof panel down so the roof to beam brackets are towards the ground. Place a middle panel onto the large roof panel assembly. Make sure the holes in the side of the panel are centered over the rafter. In the correct position, there will be a slight overhang at the top and a larger overhang at the bottom of the panel. Now place a long panel left and right onto each side of the middle panel so the ribs overlap. The long panel left and right should be flush to the rafter corner left and right and overhang the fascia beam assembly at the bottom. When the panels are aligned, attach them with four roofing screws where shown here and in page 35 of your manual. Step 14. Attach roof panels, large roof, part 2. Repeat to install a short panel left and right on the assembly. It's all right if the panels aren't perfectly flush to the corner rafters, however, they cannot overhang. If they do, remove the four roofing screws you installed earlier and adjust all the panels. When aligned correctly, secure with all the roofing screws. Step 14. Attach roof panels, large roof, part 3. On one of the large roof panel assemblies, place a spacer top so that it is flush to the outside edges and centered on the rafter top. When in position, secure with wood screws. Step 15. Attach ridge clips and roof edges, large roof. Position a roof edge left and roof edge right along the bottom of the panel assembly. Make sure the ends meet tight in the center, secure the three middle screws, then work your way from each end inwards. Peel away a small portion of the backing on the strip of weather seal, then begin attaching it to the rounded bottom of a ridge clip. When you're done applying the full length of weather seal, attach the ridge clip to one side of the small roof panel assembly so that it aligns with the angle of the rafter corner right or left. As long as one end is flush to the top of the roof panel, the other should not overhang. Take care not to push down on the ridge clip. When in position, attach it with screws. Repeat to attach a second ridge clip to the other side of the roof panel. Step 16. Attach roof panels to frame. Do not attempt step 16 in windy conditions. You'll need four people and three ladders for this step. On each short beam assembly, measure 4 feet, 4¾ inches from the inside of the post and make a mark that will be used later. Position two ladders on either side of one long beam assembly and the third ladder in the center of the frame. Get two people to lift a large roof panel over a long beam assembly. You can set the panel on the beam assembly when you need to readjust. Just make sure that two people are always supporting the panel. Be careful not to scratch the roof panels or scuff the beam with the roof-to-beam brackets when the panel is passed to the person in the center of the assembly. With one person holding the top of the panel in place, two people on the outside of the assembly can make adjustments to the panel so the corners are centered over the roof-to-post brackets. Next, move the ladders over and lift the small roof panel assembly with roof-to-beam brackets over the short beam assembly. It should fit snugly against the large roof panel, and the center roof-to-beam bracket should line up with the mark you made earlier on the short beam assembly. When the edges of the two roof panel assemblies align, connect them with three hex bolts, starting at the corner and moving upwards towards the peak. If you're having trouble getting the holes to line up, have the person in the center push up on one or more of the panels to find the right fit. Install the remaining large roof panel assembly, adjusting as needed. In the correct position, the top edges of the three panels form a square. Step 18. Attach roof peak to roof panels. Before installing the last roof panel, put the roof peak in place and loosely secure the roof peak brackets. Step 19. Attach final roof panel. Lift the last roof panel small, the one with no roof-to-beam brackets, into place over the short beam assembly. Have the person in the center push up on the peak loop to raise the roof peak so the top of the panel can slide underneath it. It may take some effort to get the fourth panel in place. To help, have the person in the center push up on one or more of the panel assemblies while another pushes in on the corners to achieve the right alignment. If the last roof panel still doesn't fit, try the following. Check to make sure it does not have the roof-to-beam brackets installed. Try loosening all six hex bolts installed during the roof panel assembly to allow for more room to adjust the panels. Check back to the roof panel assembly and make sure the roofing panels don't overhang the rafter corner right or left. Once the panel assemblies are aligned and the corners are flush, secure with bolts and tighten any bolts that you had loosened. Finally, install three roof-to-beam brackets along the small roof panel that was just installed. Steps 20 to 23, finishing touches. In step 20, secure each corner with two screws at the end of each fascia beam. For better access, you can loosen the roofing screw on the roof edge and lift it up a bit before inserting the screws into the fascia beam assembly. Next, use pan screws to secure the roof to post brackets to the roof panel assemblies. To finish each corner, attach one corner cap. From inside the assembly, attach each of the roof to beam brackets to the beam assemblies, then secure the roof peak brackets to the roof panels. Step 24. Attach ridge caps to roof panels. Remember to remove the plastic film from both sides of the ridge cap just before you're ready to install it. At each corner, slide a ridge cap over the ridge clips. Have someone in the center of the gazebo push up on the peak cap so that the ridge cap can fit underneath it. If there is an obstacle in the way, try bending the ridge clip up, then hook one side of the ridge cap long over the bent ridge clip and push down on the other side until it catches. Slide the ridge cap long up the rest of the way. Finish each corner with a ridge cap short so the ends fit under the ridge cap long. Step 25. Attach tie wrap brackets and ties. Attach a tie wrap bracket to each end of a tie so it fits tightly. Attach the bracket with one pan screw through the hole that is closer to the middle of the tie. Inside the gazebo, get a helper to hold the tie in place between two rafters so that it is level. Attach the tie bracket to each rafter with the appropriate hardware. Pre-drill through the other hole on the bottom of the tie wrap bracket before attaching it with a pan screw.